Hey guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. It's your girlfriend Elungu back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. A big shout out to everyone that has subscribed to our channel so far. Thank you for subscribing, liking, commenting, sharing, everything you guys do. We're very, very grateful, so thank you. And a big shout out to the person that suggested this. They suggested I react to the beginning and the end with Omar Suleiman, Adam Meets His Children episode 41. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
So now we go back to Adam alayhi salam. And Adam alayhi salam, as we said, all of these angels are in front of him. They've made sajda to him. And Adam alayhi salam is just waking up to this magnificent creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after showing Adam alayhi salam, you know, the angels making sajda to him, as well as Iblis refusing to make sajda, and Adam knowing that this creature hates him for nothing that he's done on his own, Adam alayhi salam is then told by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, go to those angels, and there was a gathering of them that were sitting as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and say to them, assalamu alaikum. So Adam alayhi salam is taught to say salam to them. So he goes to this group of angels as they're sitting and they're worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he says to the angels, assalamu alaikum. And they respond and they say, wa alayka assalam wa rahmatullah. And may the peace and of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon you as well. And they added the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you realize, this is a consistent theme with the conversations that Adam alayhi salam is having in paradise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first thing he told Adam alayhi salam was, Yarhamuka Rabbuk, may your Lord have mercy on you. And the angels increased upon the salam by saying, wa rahmatullah, and may the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon you as well. And this is something that when we enter paradise by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the angels are constantly coming to the children of Adam alayhi salam and saying, salamun alaykum bima sabartum, peace be unto you for the patience that you carried yourselves with in this world, because they saw the sacrifices that we've been through at this point. When they constantly, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, yadkhuluna alaykum min kulli bab, salamun alaykum tibatum. In another ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they say, salamun alaykum tibatum, you've been purified. So they're entering upon you, min kulli bab, every gate in paradise. You just have angels coming upon you saying, salamu alaykum, salamu alaykum, salamu alaykum, salamu alaykum. So this is the first conversation now between Adam and the angels. And that's a proof that the angels actually love us. They don't feel any form of jealousy from us. And in the previous conversation they had with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they questioned, you know, whether the son of Adam or whether the children of Adam would be able to maintain the earth properly, they didn't do that out of any form of jealousy or any form of envy. Rather, they love this creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, assalamu alaykum wa alayka assalam wa rahmatullah. May the peace of Allah be upon you as well as His mercy. Adam alayhi salam comes back to his Lord, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that Allah tells Adam alayhi salam, inna hadhihi tahiyyatuka wa tahiyyatu banika baynahum, that this is going to be your greeting and the greeting of your children amongst each other. Now the thing is, Adam alayhi salam still has no idea who his children are. He hasn't even been told yet that he's going to have an offspring, that he's going to have children. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Adam alayhi salam that this is going to be your greeting and the greeting that you would have between one another, Adam alayhi salam doesn't know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about in regards to his children. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then extracted the children of Adam alayhi salam from his back. And Allah presented to Adam alayhi salam all of his children, from the first of them to the last of them. Meaning, as Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, the last person that the hour would be established upon. Can you imagine, subhanAllah, Adam is seeing how many billions and billions of years of human beings is Adam alayhi salam seeing in front of him? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa says that when Adam alayhi salam sees this, all of these souls, Adam alayhi salam says, "Ay Rabbi, ma ha'ula? Oh my Lord, what are all of these?" Not who are all of these, not man ha'ula, what are these? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Ha'ula'i dhurriyatuk," that these are your children, these are your offspring. فَإِذَا كُلُّ إِنسَانٍ, the Prophet ﷺ says, so at that point, each and every single human being is standing before Adam عليه السلام, مَكْتُوبٌ عُمْرُهُ بَيْنَ عَيْنَيْهِ, and his age, or the years that he will live, is written between his two eyes. And Adam alayhi salam, as he sees all of these children, and some of them have 60 between their eyes, some of them have, you know, some of them are in the hundreds, some of them are 20. Adam alayhi salam at that point sees that one particular person lights up, is illuminating. As the Prophet ﷺ says, فَإِذَا فِيهِمْ رَجُلٌ مِنْ أَضْوَائِهِمْ, that there was a man amongst them who was from the most illuminated of them. So Adam alayhi salam says, Ya Rabbi, man hadha, as he sees this light shining, he says, Oh my Lord, who is this? The Prophet ﷺ says that Allah said to Adam alayhi salam, هَذَا بْنُكَ دَاوُودِ, this is your son, Dawood alayhi salam. كَتَبْتُ لَهُ أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً, and I've written for him 40 years. Adam alayhi salam, seeing how beautiful Dawood alayhi salam is and the nur that he has, the light that he has, he says, Ya Rabbi zidtu, oh Allah, add to his age. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذَاكَ الَّذِي كَتَبْتُ لَهُ, look, that's what I've written for him. So Adam alayhi salam says, أي ربي إني قد جعلت له من عمري 60 سنة, look, oh Allah, oh my Lord, I've given him 60 of my years. You can take from my lifespan and give to Dawood alayhi salam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَنْتَ وَذَاكَ, then if that's the case, then so it will be. Now this story has a continuation, which we'll get to inshallah ta'ala later on when Adam alayhi salam is reminded of that. But Adam gifted Dawood alayhi salam 60 of his years. Now the question is, why Dawood alayhi salam? Why would Adam alayhi salam particularly choose to give that to Dawood alayhi salam? Because the mission of Adam alayhi salam was isti'mar. As we said, it was to build. And Dawood alayhi salam would build on this earth better than anyone else. So Adam alayhi salam wanted him to have a longer life where he could establish himself more and establish the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a greater fashion. Also, Dawood alayhi salam is a prophet that's recognized for his worship even by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And nur here is what's particularly being mentioned, light. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that on the Day of Judgment, we would have light. From the effects of our wudu. Think about Dawood alayhi salam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that there is no qiyam, there is no standing up at night, that is greater than the qiyam of Dawood alayhi salam. He used to stand up for the last third of the night in prayer. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also used to stand up for the last third of the night in prayer. And there is no fasting better than the fasting of Dawood alayhi salam. Dawood alayhi salam used to fast alternate days. So he'd fast one day and break his fast the next day. Fast one day and break his fast the next day. And he continued this tradition. So Dawood alayhi salam is a prophet that combines, you know, great ibadah, great individual worship, as well as establishing the da'wah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this earth. Now, what about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Did Adam alayhi salam see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and did he recognize the greatness of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being from his children? Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu says that the Sahaba actually asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, mata wajabat laka nubuwa? O Messenger of God, when was prophethood written for you? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Wa adamu bayna ruhi wal jasad. When Adam alayhi salam was still between the phase of being body and soul. So that particular process of the soul being breathed into Adam alayhi salam, between that happening, between Adam's creation and between the spirit coming into Adam alayhi salam's body, that's when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote down prophethood for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So before Adam even breathes, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has prophethood established for him. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also says, بُعِثْتُ مِنْ خَيْرِ قُرُونِ بَنِي آدَمَ قَرْنًا فَقَرْنًا, that I have been sent as an apostle, as a messenger, in the best of all of the generations of Adam's offspring since their creation, حَتَّى كُنْتُ مِنَ الْقَرْنِ الَّذِي كُنْتُ فِيهِ, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed me in this generation that I am in. Meaning the Sahaba as well, when Adam alayhi wa sallam was looking at all of his offspring, he didn't just see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sees this generation of the Sahaba, right? The best generation that's ever walked the face of the earth. That includes people like Abu Bakr and Umar and Aisha and Khadija and these people. And they are just lit up. And this is something that's very powerful to take, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not just the greatest prophet, but he was placed within the greatest generation of the children of Adam alayhi salam. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the greatest of Adam alayhi salam's children, and to join us with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the great prophets of God and the Siddiqun and the Shuhada, the truthful ones, the martyrs, the companions, and all of those that are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah to grant us that far-reaching light on the Day of Judgment.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I hope you enjoyed and benefited from this video. If you did, then please do share it. And if you'd like to follow the rest of the series, then please do click on the top box. And if you'd like to see all of the other episodes and the other videos we have to offer, then please click on the box under that. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more amazing content.
This is very, very interesting. I feel like it's taking us all the way back to the beginning, but then that's what's confusing me. How did this actually take place? How did this conversation with God actually showing Adam his children go about? I really don't get it. Otherwise, I mean, it would be nice to know that you'd have all these children and be shown how long they'll live and what they'll do in the world and the impact they'll actually have. There's one thing I wanted to ask. What about Eve? Where was Eve at this? Oh no, since no spirit resided in Adam at that time, Eve is not yet into existence. Did God also at any point show Adam that he would given a companion? Or was that not even there? Another thing is, what's the significance? What's really the significance of God actually showing Adam his children or meeting his children? What does that mean? Did they even interact, or it's just that, or it's just one of those lessons where Adam got to know about what he would have in life? Let me know what you guys actually think. And a big shout out to the person that suggested this, and to the person that suggested this, or viewers that have more knowledge than me concerning this particular thing, please feel free to answer my questions, or feel free to educate me or make me understand this video more, and I'll appreciate. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video. You.